Bala, just mute it
Yes, sir.
on your end. Okay, whenever required, just speak. Okay, preload. We do have a event called preload, then load completed. You can mention as a load. Then we do have event called render, pre-render, and then next is render completed. These are the six events which you need to know. Rest of the things will, when we start with the view state and all those things, then you can understand the things, how it is working. Okay, but for initial stage, you should know these things. Okay, these are the concepts which is not available in the new technology, whether you are going for the core, MVC or some other parts. It's not available there. Okay, because of some reasons, I'll tell you what was the reason actually, why the Microsoft has removed these concepts from there. Okay, but in the ASP.NET, we have to follow these things. Pre-init, init completed, pre-init in simple words, init declaring your object. Init completed, allocated the memory of that object. Preload before loading the page. If you want to change something, you can go with that. Load means once the page gets loaded, entire page onto the client machine or client browser. Pre-render before rendering, because you are using ASP.NET controls. Okay, and once you execute the application, it will convert your server-side .NET controls into an HTML controls, because browser only understands HTML. Okay, whether it is XML or anything, you can just, for now, you can just consider browser supports about, browser can understand only the HTML part. So in the pre-render, what it will do, it will try to rendering the controls to the browser. Means it is converting the controls to the HTML control, means server controls getting converted into the HTML controls. That was the state of the pre-render. Render completed means every control is totally or fully gets converted into your HTML. That was the event we call as rendering completed or render. These are the five events. Whenever you go for the interview as well, they will ask you, or if you are working on that, so you can start with few events which is required, load, or sometimes you need pre-init event, this one load or render completed. Okay. But you will not find a lot of things on this. Okay, but this is a concept which the ASP.NET is working on the background. Okay, so that's why I have just shared with you. Otherwise, no one is using, but you should know these things. Let's start with the few things first, then we'll go with the other part. I'm just using ASP.NET website, okay? And the name as of, okay, we'll create a folder from today's date, right? Last day we also seen. Now this is the web config for the configuration types of things. If you want to specify, you can specify simple connection string, global variables. You can specify in the configuration file. For example, SMTP details for sending an email, you can just specify it here. It's okay. There are some namespaces, you can also put it here also. Simple page first, add new item, web form. I'm just using, I'm giving a initial thing, a login. Have we done this login.aspx somewhere, like in the past sessions? Anybody remember? I don't remember. Anyone? Shar, have we done this login.aspx in the last sessions?
No, Shar. Sir. First session, I don't know.
Okay. You were not available. I'm just, we can just cross check with the Suresh and Bala and Akshay. If not, then we'll do it. Okay, let's start with this. One page login.aspx. ASPX is nothing but active server pages extensible. Click on that. As I shared with you, this is a page directive where you want to specify which language you are going to use it. Auto event VARAP means whatever the default events for every control gets fired automatically. You don't need to do anything. Code file, whatever the, because this is a page, okay? And this, whatever the controls you are going to use it or drag it here for the designing purpose, that should interact with your server side code, means C sharp code. So I have to specify login.aspx.cs. So whenever I am adding this particular page or default.aspx or login.aspx, it will automatically create a file for that, C sharp file, login.aspx.cs. So code file for login.aspx.cs inherits which class this page is going to inherit. If you go to the login.aspx.cs, the class is login. I can use it directly here. Okay? Okay. This is a document directive. It's nothing but just only for referencing. Whatever the standards given by the W3C, you have to follow it. If you're not following it, so after 50 days, 60 days, Google will remove you from the Google search if you have not followed the standards. It will be available up to 60 days, maximum 90 days. After that, you will try to find, or if you want to access that website which you have developed and without using the standards, without following the standards, you will not be able to access your website as well. Okay, in the Google. HTML, nothing but HTML. Hypertext markup language. Head, we know. Head, whenever you wanted to specify some title of your page, you can specify here, just like this. 0 February 2018 underscore 830 batch. This is the title which I can specify. This is the head tag. Wherever I have mentioned run at equal to server, means that particular portion can be controlled, can be modified, can be processed through the server side itself. Okay. Now, I'm just writing login, for example. The body tag where you wanted to put some your code or designs, you have to specify. The form tag, if you remember in the Windows application, what we were doing, we are dragging and dropping some buttons, text boxes, and all those things. Every class, button is a class, text box is a class, every class is inheriting from the Windows.forms namespace. Okay, in the Windows application. If you want to cross check, I'll show you right away so that you can also have an idea if anything misses. For example, employee view, just double click on that, just going to the top. See, this class is inheriting from form class, where you can use the text boxes and everything. Place a cursor on the text box, you will find class system.windows.forms, means this particular text box class is available in windows.forms namespace. The same button, label, everything is coming from the Windows. Means Windows namespace. This I'm talking about this. System.windows.forms. In the same way, the website, in the even when you talk about JSP or PHP or HTML, or even if you are working with a Python, any technology, if it is a web-based, you have to specify some form tags, because every control is in a tag. Okay, you have to use it. This is the ID. Run at server means this particular form control is going to be rendered through the server, and ultimately on the client machine or client browser, it will be converted as a normal HTML. This is the div part. Whenever you talk about for creating anything onto the website, you can use it. Use some div classes and CSS I'll share with you, so that you people also try to work and create a simple web application by using doing some Googling, like how can we use a Bootstrap, Twitter, whatever CSS class we have. Once I'll complete that part, CSS and all those things, just took some templates from the Google and try to integrate in the ASP.NET itself. Okay. So then you can apply a lot of things on that. Okay. So from now, the project which I am going to use it, this particular project, whatever we are going to do, we will do it here itself. And we'll create one simple understanding. This is the form tag. Every form, whatever the tags you have opened, that must be closed. This is a design part where you can directly drag and drop your controls. Okay, but it should not a good idea to drag and drop it. For the initial time, you just write some codes. Okay, writing code. Okay. Wanted to create one table. Google. See. How to write, but I'm just helping you. If you can wanted to get it from the Google itself, for example, HTML table W3C is good, or any you can create, get it from anywhere. I just copy this part, Control C, paste it. See, the table is being created here. This is not my intention to create and dragging and dropping and copy and paste. Why? Because you should learn from the Google itself, okay, for fixing the issues and how the CSS from the Google and how you can integrate it. Okay. Because I can do it in within a 5 minutes, I can develop a one template right now. Okay. It's not a easy, like a tough task for me. But if you can also go into search those things, so you will be habitual on that, to taking the help from the Google and pasting it here so that you can integrate easily. Okay. Whoever the designer is going to develop it, he will do that. Sometimes you also need to work on that in that case. From my side, if I'm going to write, I'll create it from my end. Table is a tag. TH is for heading, but I'm just using a TR. TR stands for table row. In the table row, this TR means first row. This is the first row. Inside, just specifying TD. TD is table definition. It's nothing but a column name. I'm just using username. Okay. Now, I created one TD. Here I put it some, okay. Username text box. I have this. He is responding, that's why I'm doing again. And this should be password text box. Let me do that. I'm just creating one more button here for, yeah. Here I am writing ASP colon ASP is a prefix of ASP.NET controls. I can modify it also. I can write my name, Ashwin colon button. I can write it. I can modify it. I'll tell you at the end how can you do that. But for now, just make an habit to use ASP colon. What are the controls you know? For example, I wanted to button. ID should be unique, VTN login. Now, I'm just using a text. This is the text property equals to, I can write submit or login. The most important thing is this particular button should be controlled, should be processed, should be accessed through the server. Means I'm talking about C hash code. In that case, what we have to use, we have to specify one tag, run at to server, means it should run from the server side itself. Now, going to the design, you will see these things. Now, this is the box where this is the TD where I need to post, put my text box. So what I am doing, just see, this is the text, okay. I will go here, removing this, I am putting ASP colon, text box ID equals to txt username. And at equal to server, you must have to be specify the. Okay. The TDA, I have created it. Now I'm just pasting and doing this txt password. Okay, things are being done or created. Now the next intention is, for example, if somebody wants to specify some CSS or styling, so there is a table tag, you can specify your style under it. Hey, style, these are the basic HTML. To type style, if you want to specify the coloring for the entire table, you have to use the table tag for styling. If you want to specify on a particular row, you can write the code here itself, style, then you can write it. Okay, so for now what I am doing, style equals to, I'm just writing border colon, I'm just passing two pages. Now I have to specify border. I have not given a border color actually. It was not. Design. Border color is to. Let's put. Dimension on this. So this is a property of the table itself. Okay, but we can use in the style as well. Okay, we'll tell you. Okay, I have given these things. Okay, and there's something called some other properties as well. Might be they have not ceased. I just say, but rules. Rules equals. The double quotes. And do like this. Okay. I wanted to expand the table and all those things. If I wanted to make this as a center, so you have a pop attribute called justify center. Entire thing. Now, if can somebody tell me if I wanted to place the entire table? Should be visible in the center of the page. The HTML, right? Can I put some div tag? Div is for the division. Okay, I can put it here like. It's a division part only. Inside that, I can make the design of this particular div so that table should come in the middle of the page. I can specify some styling and all those things. Okay. I have shared with you this particular day because we have to work on the styling on the same page. I'll come back on the same page for the designing again. Okay, so right now what we are going to see, let's start with that. The first requirement is I want to specify some validation control here itself. So to specify the validation controls, can I do something like facebook.com? Okay. Log out it first. Okay. See, I'm not entering anything. And I am clicking on create account. See, it is throwing some errors. Particular, this message is coming using a bootstrap. They have uses the inbuilt bootstraps. Twitter bootstrap, CSS classes. Okay. So you can also apply the same. But the .NET itself, still people are using some validation controls here. You can find the validation controls. Okay. Okay. I'm adding one more page here. Add new item for sign up. I have added it. I'll use both the things. Okay. You have to write the code from your end. I'm just using some inbuilt feature, insert table. Okay. I'm just writing here first name. Tomorrow I'm expecting you should do something different. Okay. Please dragging and dropping, but you should make a practice on just writing the code which I had did on login page. First name, last name. I'm just keeping the text boxes here. And see to the source side, the code is getting generated automatically. Okay. The TD is also there. I can write something here itself. TD, then I can put email, something. I can put a text box. I can copy and paste it. I can make it as. Let's see that. It is automatically getting generated. Now, password. I'm just putting it. There is a confirm password. Text boxes. Let's click. I'm just putting one button here. Properties. I'm just giving a text. I'm also mentioning as create account. Create account. Here I'm giving BTN. Create account. Now let's quickly we'll change the variable name so that we can use it. Txt first name. F name I'm typing it. Second text box is txt L name. Txt email. PhD password. PhD confirm password. See, my intention is not to show only these concepts like how we are dragging and dropping and only doing some validations. Okay. My intention is little bit different. I'll tell you once we did. Complete this thing. Now, for example, I am going to run this application and I have set this page. If I wanted to run this page, just right click on it, make it as set as start page. Now it's okay. Now, I shared with you one thing on the last session, ASP.NET enable or debugging enable or disable. Okay. Whenever you are using a Visual Studio, you have to specify enable debugging. Means the first radio button should be selected in the ASP.NET itself. Okay. If you are deploying the application, go with this one. Okay. But there is a mode for debugging and releasing to publish the code. I'll share with you at the end how can we publish the code on the IIS and then you can access it. Okay. So for now, for the development purpose, you have to use the modify the web config for file to enable debugging. When I click OK, mistake, sorry. Whenever I am clicking this icon, on the bottom side you see ASP.NET development server, because every web application requires a particular web server where you can host your applications. So Microsoft is following with IIS, Internet Information Services, Java is following with the, I think so, Tomcat, and PHP is following followed by like Apache. So these are the text boxes. On the preview, I need to do some validation. Give you a specific validation, but you need to do in a different way. Okay, let's start with first thing. Help you. How can you do that? How can you achieve that? But you have to make a practice so that in the MVC or any other framework which you are going to use it in the .NET Core, you have to use those things which we will learn it. Now, I'm placing a breakpoint. These are some standard validation controls. Still, it is useful. You cannot deny it. The first validator control, we have a required field validator. I'm placing it here. Required field validator. First name is required. This one is should required. For the email, I can directly specify regular expression. For the password, okay. For the password, I can make it as what we call required. Password is also required. For the confirm password, I'll tell you. Okay. Just selecting a particular required field validator, I can make the changes of this. REQ, required. Required first name. Make it. I can write required last name. If I am changing the ID, you must have to be change it from your end whenever you are working. Required email. Second would be required password. Okay. Now, the next step is, this is the required field validator. I have to assign two properties. Make a note for that. What are the two properties which you need to specify? The first one would be control to validate this required field validator. One second. Yes, sorry. So this is the required field validator. We have to specify two properties and make a note for that. The first property is control to validate. Which control you are going to associate with this particular required field validator? TXT first name. I have to specify the error message. First name is required. Something. Last name is required. I can do lot of things in these controls. Just wait for few more minutes only, then I'll show you. Control to validate, we have to specify last name. Okay. Control to validate email. Sorry. Message I have to specify email. For the email, email is not valid, and for this I have to specify the expression here. You can specify custom or anything for the text box, which is whatever required. Now going to the internet email address, okay, it is predefined. Then required field validator for the password, I can make your name as password required. And control to validate wherever you want to specify this. You can change the colors and properties as well. See, this is something like four color. Okay, that's red. Okay. So just copying and pasting it. Whatever I did, was implemented here itself in the source side. See, properties. First thing, this is the text box. This is the required field validator which I have created it or dragged it. Control to validate is the first property which you need to specify. This particular required field validator should associate, should attach with which text box txt first name. Error message, it's up to us to define it. The message first name is required or first name is mandatory, something error message. The four color, even though you can get the properties here itself, just specifying the space bar. See, I can give it. Okay, we'll do one by one. For the last name, email, everywhere we have specified, done it. Now let's I'm not entering anything. See, clicking onto the create account, it is throwing some error. Got it? If I enter it, tab, done. Enter it, create account, done. Password. See, clicking onto the create button. The second part is login.exe. I wanted to show something. Email address. Okay, I have not shared with you that email address. Okay, let me check with you. See, something I have entered it. See, email is not valid. What it is requires actually abc.net@gmail.com. It is looking for the dot sign and the @ sign. That's it. It is valid now. If I enter something else, see, I'm deleting it. Press tab. See, is valid. That's true. Email address or whatever you specify, customer. Okay. I did it. Then we have one more control here. We call compare validator. Compare validator is nothing but for comparing the confirmed password or the password value. Going to the properties, to specify two properties here. Control to validate. To which control you are going to associate